This is a drill that I find is really helpful as like an accessory to your training to help you get a little bit better at your muscle ups. So, turn this down just a little. Come on over here around the rings if you can move. Kelly, you can just roll over here if you want to. Crawl on all fours. So, the hard part of the muscle up for almost everybody isn't the pull or the push. And once you get your pull up and your dip down, it's there. It's not going to go anywhere. It's this proximal strength in here real close to the body. And all the muscle up really is, once you've pulled to your chest here, is rotating yourself into this position on top of the rings. And that's a lot of strength really tight and close to your body. And most of our pulling strength is done to about here. Maybe here if you do like a chest to bar pull up. So really want to work on getting strong through here. And it's also a good way to practice that transition. So check it out. The way we start this thing is in the bottom of a dip. And it's kind of a false dip because my feet are on the ground. But the cool thing about this is as I rock out of this, I'm going to get practice re-establishing my false grip. You guys familiar with that false grip? If you're not, it's a funny looking grip that you use when you do muscle ups, where I basically put the heel of my palm here, kind of that pivot point, the natural pivot point with the wrist in the hand. I'm going to hook that on the wrist, on the ring rather, and then reach back and grip the ring with that wrist still on the ring. You guys ever do arm wrestling? You know how to win in arm wrestling? Over the top. Over the top, right? It's the same thing. So I hook that into position. And then I go down for my muscle up. It's really hard to establish that though on the way down unless you practice it. So we're going to go from this bottom of the dip. I'm going to rock back, not down, but back. I'm going to establish that position. I don't even care if you straighten your arms out now. You don't have to do this. You can keep them hooked. And then I'm going to very slowly pull to my chest and turn back through. Now that's kind of the basic way to practice this, but if you're struggling, like I said, with that close kind of proximal strength, the way I like to do it is here. And this is what I think you should probably do, Heather. So from here, I rock back, I establish the false grip, but I never let them leave my body. I have to stay in contact. And then I pull my hands into my armpits, rotate my shoulder back through. This is not easy at all, particularly this point, because my hands just want to rip away from my chest so bad right now. And I'm working just keeping them as close as I can, never letting them leave. And I'm practicing this groove of rocking back and forth between on the rings, below the rings and on the rings, below the rings and on the rings. And I want you to notice also I'm not actually going up and down. A lot of people think the muscle up is like I'm below and then I go up two and back down. All this is me rotating my hands, rotating my shoulder below to over top by pulling my hands back into my armpits and dropping my chest towards the floor. So I want you guys to try to get a low set of rings. Cool, so you go ahead and just toe squat for me, Kelly. That's it, yeah. So you've got the false, you've done this before, right?
No.
Oh, good, you've got the false grip solidly, that's great. So now what I want you to do is pull your hands and elbows in, use your legs to help you and just kind of stand up till it's kind of against your chest here, and now go into the deepest dip of your life. Just swipe your hands to your armpits, turn your chest towards the ground, and you get your shoulder on top of that ring. That's it. So yeah, you just pulled a little bit higher than we need. So you're pulled to here. I want you to pull to here. So go back down. Good, so pull all the way down to the sternum, a little deeper. Like think like nipple line, there you go, good. Now roll your shoulder on top of that ring. Pull your hand into your armpit. Right there, so yeah, you're a little block. Here, watch. So check it out. If I don't pull deep enough here, my shoulder runs into the ring.
Okay.
But if I pull basically, like I said, to like nipple line or deeper, that allows me to put my shoulder on top of the ring.
Oh, okay.
So just a little deeper pull is going to help you out. Heather, do you want to try that drill that I showed? I think it's going to work for you. So pull real deep. Use your legs to help you. Don't. Yeah, now just transition down into the bottom of a dip. That's the basic movement. That's a good start. Now check it out.
I'm still not.
No, you're real close. So all you need to do now is instead of kind of standing up into it,
yeah.
I want you to pull and then I want you to just roll your shoulder over into the bottom of that dip. Okay. Exactly. Try one more. So toe squat, so pull to right here and then pause for me. Good, now think about it this way. Right there, that's a great pull. Go under my hand into the bottom of the dip. That's better. So you feel how close you stay to the rings that time?
Yeah.
That's what we need.
Okay.
So instead of thinking like you're not doing like a rainbow, you're just shooting right into the bottom of that thing. Heather, let me see what you got. So yeah, right there, keep them touching your body. So you went up again, right?
Okay.
So I want you to come
forward.
I want you to lean back.
Okay.
So you're making it easy by bending. Straighten your legs out all the way. Good, now, feel how you already can't touch, so we made it too hard. So I want you to start in the bottom of your dip, put your toes to my foot. Now, without letting those hands ever leave your shirt, rock back and hang. Touching your chest, touching your chest, touching your chest. There you go. Nope, they left. Pull them. Now rock back into the position. Good. So you use this to rock?
Yeah.
Next time I want you to do, watch me. I don't want any movement other than what your arms are doing. Here.
Okay.
Here.
Okay.
So no kip, no throwing the hips, no kicking the legs. Not because that's bad. Yeah, it's good. You're getting the work done. I just want you to get that strength piece done. Good. Now lean back. Don't let your hands leave your shirt. Don't let them leave. Don't let them leave. Don't let them leave. Pinch them together. Now pull your hands. There you go. Good. So if that's easy, now move your toes to my foot again. Try again.
Get it.
You got it. Don't let them leave. Don't let them leave. Don't let them leave.
Yeah, girl.
Straight legs. Pull. Oh, and that's where we see it. Yeah, the wing out. That's a good place for you to work because
okay.
I want you to get where you're here.
Okay.
Just as tight as you can be without having to fight for it so hard. That's a good spot. I'd even put like a chalk line there for you. Cool. All right, guys, if you're done, if you don't want to play on the rings anymore, let's get you out of here.